Hello, Pale Blue Daughters. RESO has a new update. I recently reviewed RESO, link up above, and I was using a pre-release version of the plugin. They just released their first important update, so I wanted to revisit it with the new features. Let's dive in. But first, please like and subscribe, and hit the bell for notifications. Plus, I've started a Patreon where you can get early video views, mix feedback, and other benefits. Check it out, and head over to paleblue.ca for free goodies and information on my upcoming mini course. In my original review, one of the main issues with RESO was that it didn't sound like it was doing much when I engaged the targets. Even lowering the nodes didn't make much of a difference, leading me to wonder if the plugin is just too subtle for most users. I found that I got the best results by finding my own resonance, then increasing the filter Q width to hear more appreciable results. But in this new 1.01 update, mastering the mix tweaked the EQ width a little bit, so when you engage the targets, you actually hear a bit more of a difference. Let's check it out on a nasty mix. RESO needs to analyze the audio and set its targets. There, and now we hit engage targets. And we can definitely hear it making some big changes here. And we can see there are some huge dips here in the mids and the highs if we bypass. We can really hear those resonances now when we bypass. I think this is a big improvement, but it sounds like a little too much, so I'm going to adjust the nodes to decrease attenuation. And that's where the next part of the update comes in handy. Since RESO doesn't have a threshold per se, to make global reduction changes, you have to group all the faders by drag selecting them, then move them in unison. The problem with RESO 1.0 was that the nodes would not move uniformly. After a certain point, the nodes would start flattening out, and you lose the relative balance between the target nodes. This would essentially ruin the careful work you've been doing, and you'd have to start over. But now, ganging the faders has improved. I can raise and lower them all at the same time, and they maintain their relative positions. However, I found that if you hit the edges of the display, once again, the EQ nodes start evening out and will eventually all have the same gain. Just so I know I'm not going bananas, let's check this behavior in a similar plugin. Oh, let's say soothe2? Alright, so here when I select all the EQ nodes and move them together, I can see they perfectly retain their relative positions. Even if I smash them all around the edges, soothe2 always retains perfect relativity between the nodes. So this is what I expect RESO to do. Now, to be clear, it's not that likely that you'll want to make relative adjustments so severe that you need to use the vertical limits of the screen. But it could pose a problem if you have one very deep cut and need to pull the whole EQ curve down. There we go, back to flat. This is why I'd like to see a global threshold parameter to make things like this quick and easy. My first instinct when I opened the plugin was to grab the red bar up top and pull it down, but alas, it doesn't work that way. However, I'm very happy to see the relative target nodes moving together in unison. The strange behavior with relative unison moving is not a deal breaker, and I'll bring it to the developer's attention. Another improvement is that the Q width adjustments are much smoother with the mouse wheel now. It seemed to be very 0 to 100 before, but now it responds as expected. I'm moving the mouse up and down, and this is quite smooth. I can control it much more easily. They even included an option in the preferences to have a slower setting for mouse wheel speed, so that's great to see. Plus, there are some more under-the-hood adjustments, like increased compatibility with WaveLab. Good news for me. Now that mastering the mix have made some crucial adjustments to RESO, I can recommend it more strongly as a resonance suppressor alternative to soothe2 and DSEQ. I still have some issues with the interface, and I find that this is usually the case with their plugins, but I think most users will be pleased with the results they hear right away with minimal fuss. And you can pick RESO up right now at ADSR for only $59, which is even cheaper than the discount at Mastering the Mix's site. This puts it in the same price range as Smooth Operator, but you get more filter nodes with RESO. Use my affiliate link below and support the channel. That's all for now. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe and head over to paleblue.ca and sign up for my newsletter. Plus, you can get information on my new mini course about mixing. Until next time, mix well.